Hello everyone, in this video we will see paging from memory management. Paging is a concept where physical address space of a process can be non-contiguous. So since it is non-contiguous, the process will be allocated in the main memory frame by frame or page by page. Dividing the physical memory into fixed size blocks is called as frames, and dividing logical memory into blocks of a same size is called as pages. If it is a physical memory, then it is called frames, and the same into a logical memory we call it as pages. To access frames you need physical address, but to access the pages it is like a logical and address of a CPU is enough. To keep track of all the free frames, you make use of this paging concept. To run the program of any size, if there is no limit, if the size of a RAM is 1 GB and the size of a program may exceed 1 GB, then the paging concept come into existence, where you can find n free frames and the load the program into it. Set up a page table and translate logical address to physical address, and then you can access the frames. But the problem here is paging still suffers from internal fragmentation. Address translation for paging happens with page number and page offset value. Page number will be used as an index into a page table with continuous or contains base address of each page in a physical memory, and offset is combined with the base address to define the physical memory of the address. So page number will be always an offset value, which means physical logical address, which is combined with the offset value to get the physical address. For a given logical address space 2 power m, then the size of a page or the page size will be 2 power n. This is how paging hardware looks. So the paging hardware contains paging hardware will contains a page table, which is also a part of main memory. So this page table will have a logical address, and then it is transferred into frames by adding it with a physical offset value. CPU always gives a logical address which is having page number and the offset value. The page number will contain the frame number of a physical address. The frame number is added with the physical address, that is our offset value D. The D in page number as well as frame number will be same. By adding frame number with the offset value, it will get the physical address, which is actually stored in the physical memory. So paging model of logical and physical memory looks like this. Whenever you have a physical memory is always with a frame numbers and a data of pages is stored. Logical memory will contains a page number, and page table will have the actual or physical address in the main memory. Let's consider page 0. Page 0 is in the page table for the logical address. So logical address of page table is at the 0, and the frame number of that logical address is in the 1th physical address. So page 0, 0th index has 1 frame. So physical address is for the page 0 is under the physical address of 1. So logical memory is taken to the page table, converted into physical address, found the address. If I take page 3, 3 index in the page table will be stored in 7th frame of the physical memory. So in the physical memory 7, the value or the data containing with the page 3 is saved. This is how paging model converts logical address to physical address, or logical memory to physical memory. So here we have a normal bigger example where how paging is converted to a frame address. Let's consider the data from 0 to 3, where ABCD data is the page. So at the index 0, if I see in the page table, the data is stored in fifth memory address. If we go to the memory address 5, which is like fifth frame, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6, sorry, it should be from 0, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Since the memory always starts with 0, so frame number starts with 0. If I see the 5th block, I have the data ABCD. If I consider 12, 13, 14, 15, you should be having MNOP. This is the logical address space where the data is saved in continuous order, but in the data actually stored in address table. 0, 1, 2, 3. Third page will contain the data of MNOP, which is stored in the second frame. If I go to the frame number second, we have the actual data MNOP present under physical memory. This is how the data is converted from logical address space to physical address space, means pages to frames, and CPU can access the logical address defined with the help of page table and actually gets the physical data from the main memory. So this is where free frames is allocated, or this is how a free frames is allocated. Before allocating, let's consider the frames in the main memory was empty. So free frame list is 14, 13, 18, 20, 15 and so on. Page 0, page 1, 2, 3 are the new process. So if I take the free frame list, from the free frame list, the pages will start allocated and a new process table will be started. So page 0 is allocated to 14, then page 1 to 13, page 2 to 18, page 3 to 20, and the frame left is 15. So now if I see page 0, it is stored under the 14th frame, 1 is stored under 13th frame, 2 is stored under 18th frame, and 3 is stored under 20. So in the page table, page 0 is saved in 14th frame, page 1 is stored in 13th frame, page 2 is stored in 18th, and page 3 is stored in 20. So this is how a free frame is allocated to each and every page by the help of free frame list, and new process will copy each and every page to those frames. So implementation of page table is like, page table is kept in a main memory itself. Page table has a base register called PTBR, page table base register, where points to the page table is allocated. Page table length register will indicate the size of the page table. So these are the two registers which is helping the page table to be accessed by the operating system. In this scheme, every data or instruction access requires two memory access. One is from the page table, one more is from the data or instructions. The two memory access problem can be solved by use of specific fast lookup hardware called as cache or cache, called active memory or translation look aside buffer. So active memory is one which helps to, like, since we are using pages and frames, the access between the memory will be slow because you are accessing to two level of memory. To reduce the burden of two memory access, there is one more hardware which is cache is introduced, which is called as active associative memory or transition look aside buffer. TLB is one more new hardware allocated with paging hardware, which helps to access to two-way memory faster. So we have the same hardware which is introduced with TLB. So page table will be having frame numbers, and this TLB will contains direct page number with a frame number and physically accessed. Since it is a cache, it is limited and it is small than the page table. If the value is not present in the TLB or transition look aside, aside buffer, then there will be a TLB miss generated by operating system for the logical address provided by CPU. So that logical address which is TLB miss will be searched in the page table and then it is converted to frame number and physical address. So since this TLB is from cache and this is from main memory or the physical memory, cache is fastest compared to the main memory and the paging hardware becomes faster than the previous normal version. So next one is effective access time. Effective access time is the amount of time which is used for accessing the physical address, converting it into logical address and fetching the data from the main memory. If the access means the effectiveness of access time will be based on the number of like the amount of time where the operating system is utilizing its time in the execution, not in accessing the data. So associative lookup is equal to eta time unit, which can be lesser than 10% of memory access time. So in the 100% of your CPU execution, it access time should not be lesser or should not be greater than 10%. It should be always lesser than 10%. Hit ratio is an alpha. The alpha value is the percentage of time that the page number is found in the associative register. Consider alpha is 80% and eta is 20 nanosecond for TLB search. Then if you have 100 nanoseconds in memory access, the effective time access or the access time EAT will be 140 nanoseconds. Memory protection is like the protection given by the operating system for copying or reading the data and writing the data. So for the files, if you are having a file in your user, there will be read-only access or read-or-write access allowed by the operating system. Valid and invalid bit attached to the each and every page table. So valid bit indicates the process can be accessed through the logical address space and invalid bit indicates the page is not in the process logical address space. So you have to go to page table and then or in the frame to get the frame or it should go to the storage unit, get the frame to the main memory, then this invalid bit is converted to valid bit, so you can get the valid access to that page table. Any violation results in trap to the kernel. It gives the trap. So here we have how a valid bit and invalid bit actually work. If you have a pages from 0 to some data, so there are 5 pages in the main memory, which is under 0 to 12 to 87th address. If the page is found, like page 0 is in the frame 2, if it should be valid. So if I go to the frame 2, you find the page 0 content. But if I consider page 6 and 7, there is no pages in 6 and 7, there is no frames allocated, so value is 0 here and it is invalid. It is not like page 0's value is present, instead there is no data in that frame, so the bit is invalid. If I add there is a page 6 in the page number instead in the position of any free space, like let's consider 6, I have to update 6 value with the data 6 and the bit will be converted to valid if you have the data access for the page 6. If there is no frame existing or the data existing in the frame number, then the valid bit is converted to invalid. There is no need for an operating system to check invalid bits while accessing the frames. Next one is shared pages. Shared code is like one of the used method where one copy of read only code shared among the process. It may be like text editor, compilers, window system, similar to multiple threads sharing the same process space, which allows useful for inter-process communication if sharing the read-or-write pages is allowed. So this share code is like, if you are using a process which is intercommunicating, then you can access the shared code in the form of read only, so that the other process which is utilizing your code will not edit it. Private code and data is like, each process keeps a separate copy of code. Instead of sharing the data, if two process is utilizing same code, then each process will keep the separate copy of the code and data. The page for the private code and data can appear anywhere in the logical address space. Shared page, like we'll see the example of shared pages, where you have process P1 and P2 which is utilizing E1, E2, ED2, ED3 and data 1, where process P3 is utilizing ED1, ED2, ED3 and data 3, and the page table will look similar for the code which is similar. ED1, ED2, ED3 here in the process 1 is same as ED1, ED2, ED3 of process 3. So if I see the logical address or the page table of both the process, the page table values are also similar for each other when they are utilizing same data set. So process 2 will have the same data and the page table is same. So the data is shared by three processes, ED1, ED2, ED3, and the data, like execution data, is shared by all the processes, and the variable data, that is executing data which is changed at the time of execution, are kept separate, so that each process should not modify others' data. So the read-only data can be shared, but writable data should be kept separately for each process. This is the concept of shared memory, which saves the time in accessing the memory, or it also saves the frames, or it also uses effective use of single frame for multiple processings. So I guess you understood these topics. Thank you.